Hi guys, I'm making some meatloaf. I don't eat a lot of red meat, but sometimes I have a taste for it. So I'm going to show you my recipe. Well, actually, my mom makes it this way. Sometimes she makes it a little different, but it's basically very similar. What you're going to need is a slice of bread. It could be old bread that was going to throw away, but it's still pretty good. You need one egg, less than half of some onion, canned milk, a little canned milk, seasoned salt, black pepper, a little bit of oatmeal. I usually use tomato paste or tomato soup. I ran out of it. I thought I had some. So I'm going to put a little bit of this pasta sauce. You could use the regular spaghetti sauce. You're not going to put much of it in. You'll see how much I put in. And I may add some ketchup on top. But this is not really necessary, unless you just want it that way. Also, some people add a little bit of sugar if they want it a little bit sweeter. So I'm going to begin. You see, I have the chopped meat. Put a little bit of the seasoned salt in, just a little bit. A little bit of the black pepper. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take a tablespoon of this oatmeal, and I'm just going to put that amount in. Just going to put that in there. I asked my mother why she uses the oatmeal. She said it makes it more nutritious, so have to do it like mama. I'm almost finished with this canned milk, so I'm going to put just a little bit in there, like that. You can see this all. Now I'm going to crack the egg and put it in there. Take the one piece of bread and start crumbling it up into your mixture here with the beef and all the other ingredients. And the bread helps it mold a little better. Some people leave out the bread. Some people leave out the oats. So you would have to decide whether you want to use it both, or if you don't like the taste of the oats, which you can't really taste the oats in there. See how I crumbled it in there? Now the pasta sauce or the spaghetti sauce. I'm going to take my tablespoon. I'm going to add 3 of these. And if I stir it up and it looks like I need more, I think I do need more. I'm going to put 2 more. I'm going to cut up my onion. I'm going to put a little less than half. If you don't like onions, you don't have to add it. Also, sometimes I put the green peppers in there, but I'm out of that today also. And you really don't have to put it. So I'm putting this much of onion in there. old. I think I'm going to add the sugar. That is not something that you have to add. It's just something that I do sometimes. For me, it tastes a little bit better, but you don't have to do it. So, take a tablespoon and get my sugar from up here in this container. There's the sugar, and I'm sprinkling that in there. And then you start stirring. You stir this all up together. Now, this is how it looks after you stir it up. Some people taste a little bit of this raw meat. I don't do that because it's not healthy. So if you feel that it's not enough salt or whatever, I will put some more after the meatloaf is done. Let everybody add their own because it's not something that you want too salty. Now, this is my little hot pan or whatever you want to call it. I'm going to put it in there. Take my hands. Wash my hands. Going to mold it into the position that you want it to be in. Not nothing so fancy. Make it kind of like a log. That's how it looks. At this point, you can put a little bit of the ketchup on it, or you could wait till it's almost done. I think I'm going to wait till it's almost done to put the ketchup on. Now, wash my hands again. I'm going to put this in the oven at 350. I'm going to check it every 15 minutes. Now, it's going to take about 30 minutes. It may take an hour. It depends. But when you see it looking all brown and everything, you'll be able to tell that is done, because it's going to look done. So I'm going to put it in 350, put it in my oven, and what I'm going to do is, when it's done, I will be back, I will show you how it looks, and I'm also going to just open some canned vegetables or something and decide what else I'm going to have with it. So I will talk to you guys soon.
Gorgeous women and gorgeous gentlemen, looks like my dinner is done. I'm going to take it out and let you see what I got here.
I put off camera, I put the ketchup on top. All you gotta do is put it on and smooth it on like that. That's it. So, this is what my meatloaf looks like. Does it look delicious? And I just made, macaroni and cheese in a box, no big deal.
And
some string beans. So I'm going to show it on the plate. I'm going to make my plate. Thought my daughter was coming over, but looks like she's coming tomorrow. I really was cooking for her and my grandbaby. But it will be some left tomorrow. This is a very easy meal. I had someone ask me, one of my friends, she said, "You cook even when nobody's at your house?" Yes, I do. My mother loves to cook and I do too. I try to cook something, a little something every day. Do is just follow those instructions. If you like a little more seasoning in it, you just add a little more seasoning to your taste, and then you have yourself a nice hearty meal. Doesn't that look delicious? So this is my, well, not all my recipe, because like I told you, this is my mother's recipe, but thank God for Mom. Look how delicious this food looks. So I'm getting ready to eat, and I will talk to you wonderful, beautiful people later. Bye.